The world is full of stories. Taradiddles, jokes and nonsense, gossip and tall tales. Stories to make you happy. Stories to make you prickle and shiver with goosebumps. Or to pass the time on a long journey. Stories about the past. The naughtiest thing your mum and dad ever did at school. That time when you were so very happy. Or were so terrified. Stories read. Stories written. Stories imagined. Stories told. But where do all these stories come from? It's not just books, you know. Stories are the glue that hold us together, that keep us suspended between the past and the future. Now, we humans have been around on this earth for about 200,000 years. Books as we know them have been here for about 500 years. So that means that for 199,500 years, stories were passed on another way. And guess how that happened? We've told them, chatted, and whispered by the fireside to our families and our children, and even in the House of Commons. Begin to imagine. Let your thoughts run free as you wonder, where did all these stories come from?
Have you heard the one about down in the hollow?
Box.
Where's the water?
One bright day.
What's in your pot?
Where's your mum?
In Barney's barn.
When I was little. Back in the day.
Where's Mouse's?
Way back when.
There is a tree on an island, far away, and yet it's nearer than you can possibly imagine. It's a big tree with a fat trunk. And there's a door where you can walk right into the middle of the tree. Its branches are stretched wide and twisted. It has leaves with the titles of stories on them. These leaves whisper stories into your ear, especially if you tuck one under your pillow at night. The tree has fruits and seeds too, all the colours of the rainbow, bursting full of words, all waiting to be heard. When you eat the juicy, sweet fruits from the tree, you can hear stories in your head. We're going to take you there today. It's easy. You just need to catch a bus from the bus station. Of course, first you need a ticket. You can buy one at the local shop. Just ask for a rainbow ticket, and the shopkeeper knows where to look. They're kept in a box. Inside a box. Within a box. And inside that box glitter the rainbow tickets. You can't miss the bus, it's golden. It glimmers magically and invitingly in the sunshine, as if to say, hop on board. There's room for everyone. And we mean everyone. Right, well, let's go. We can't go any further, for here's the river, rushing and swooshing, hurdling and hurrying along, rolling and tumbling between us and the island of the story tree. If we're going to get to that island, we'll need to make one big, giant, enormous, mammoth, mighty, powerful leap of your imagination. Come on, you can do it. Jumping, springing, leaping, and together we'll get there. We made it. High five the person next to you. This is the island. The tree stands tall. There's a certain sparkle to the leaves. It's heavy with stories, riddles, rhymes, jokes, nonsense, and facts. Green leaves, broad and bursting, with stories ready to be heard, told and written. It's seen thousands of years, many seasons. Winter, when it's snowy and shiversome. Spring, with sudden sharp showers of rain, blusters of wind and bursts of bright sun. Summer, when it's hot and still. We can shelter under the leaves for shade. And autumn, when the leaves come tumbling down. These leaves are precious, for each one has a story to tell. A tale which wants to be heard. They must be gathered, harvested, stored, sorted, and dispatched. So here comes the truck. It's a sort of backwards fire engine with enormous hoses which don't spurt water, but instead they suck up the stories, hoovering up the libraries of tales which lie brightly on the ground. The stories are taken to the depot and packed into boxes by a team of dedicated elves.
We have.
When ready, the boxes sprout wings, and off they fly. Out of the packaging room window, off over the river to the hills, to the towns, to the mountains and the countries beyond. Flapping and flurrying far away, taking their magic words and imaginings on their busy wings. Where does all this magic come from? How can a tree make all this happen? Well, it's simple. The tree's power comes from an ancient source, an old energy which is never in short supply, never runs out, never needs recharging. And most importantly, it's free. It's simply the power of a story. The more that there are stories told, the more laughter, and smiles, and excitement. The sound of enjoyment, that's what keeps this marvellous tree going. Year after year, time after time, season after season, leaf upon leaf, tale after tale. I'm sorry, everyone. We seem to have a power failure. Sorry, this wasn't supposed to happen. Technical support? Sorry, this is embarrassing. I'm really sorry. We haven't got enough power. We're too distracted by our phones, by our screens, our emails, our gadgets. We need more words, we need more stories. We need more tales.
Let's make it real.
Who said that?
Me.
Who are you?
I'm a child and I know how much I love stories. Texts and emails aren't enough. Messages won't do. We need to talk to each other in real time with our mouths, tongues, lips and eyes. Let's try it.
I guess anything's worth a try. Okay, turn to the person next to you and talk to them. Tell them something, anything, what you did last night, your favourite place to go to eat, your favourite meal, your worst meal, the thing you can't bear to eat. Tell them something. Tell them about the naughtiest thing you ever did. We need real words, real stories, real connections. There are real words. Things that actually exist. It's working. The power's coming back. We did it. With all these stories zooming around and flying off in boxes, I'm sure some of them are heading for Telford, for your school. I know how much you love a good tale at Old Park. They'll be flying through the letterboxes and the cracks in your curtains at home too. We'd better get there. And quick. We'll have to leap over the river, back on the bus, and head for home.
Thank you.
And that was the tale of the story tree.